Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcat. I'm going to talk about Emantic Bradford, a young black man in his early 20s who was shot and killed by the police in a shopping mall where there was some type of dispute, some type of active shooter situation. Now, originally the authorities said that, hey, this guy was a shooter. He was involved with an altercation with an 18-year-old male. He shot the 18-year-old male and shot a 12-year-old female. That was the original story. This all supposedly happened on Thanksgiving Eve, night in Alabama. But then the story narrative changed. The police came out and said, hey, okay, he wasn't the shooter because of the forensic evidence. He apparently had a gun on him, but he didn't fire his gun. And the police also interviewed some witnesses that apparently said that Bradford was trying to wave people away from the violence. So he was trying to help the situation. What's bizarre is that the family came on television and said that the police didn't even reach out to them. Which, you know, I understand why the police don't want to come out and say, hey, we're sorry we did this, because that could be used against them in the court of law, but in a civil suit. But I mean, if you shoot an innocent guy, yeah, you're going to end up in a civil suit. I think sometimes you have to balance, as a police department, I like to see them balance the liability issue with community relations and optics, or a little bit of, yeah, I like to see all that sort of balanced in, because, you know, you can do more harm by your response to a situation like this than even the actual situation. Because I think a lot of people would understand if they came out and said, we made a mistake, it was a terrible situation, and they showed some empathy, people would empathize more with them, with the police department. Because, you know, if you're a cop, you're responding to an active shooter situation, and you're told that, hey, somebody's shooting, and your goal is to get there to stop the threat, stop more people from getting shot and killed, you want to prevent a massacre. So you get there and you see some guy with a gun, whether he's black or white, it's a guy with a gun. Hopefully the police officer will take measures to try to make sure that's the right person, that's the bad guy, not just another person responding to that, because people do have concealed carry permits. Apparently this guy did too, according to his father, because his father and mother went on television and talked about him. The father was a correctional officer, and a correctional officer, he said, hey, it doesn't matter if I was a CO for 25 years, I would expect them to reach out and give me this information, no matter who I was. You know, personally, I'm thinking it's just part of being a human being. You know, I don't understand why people have such anger against authority figures, especially law enforcement, because it's how a lot of these agencies handle these situations just like this. Anyway, there's a body cam out there, and apparently it's being turned over to the Alabama Law Enforcement Agency. I think it's a state agency is going to look over this situation. And again, I can understand the police officer's perspective, and I understand why the police officer isn't really coming out and saying much anything right now for legal reasons, but somebody in the department should say something. Now, I think so, because, you know, if you care about having any type of meaningful relationship with your community, I mean, come on, like I said, empathy will go a long way. And I think people can understand the mistake, but when something like this happens, an innocent person gets shot, and it turns out that Bradford wasn't the shooter, and you don't say anything, it looks really, really bad. So what's weird is that there's been protests. Well, that's not weird. There's Black Lives Matter protests in various places. I think they shut down a highway at one point recently. What's really, really weird is that the real shooter got away. The real bad guy got away. And we're not hearing anything about this person. We're not hearing anything about his description or anything. Has this person been arrested or anything? That's the most bizarre thing about this thing. And here we are talking about how the police responded to the situation. You know, as a concealed carry holder, a person with a concealed carry permit holder, and here in Kentucky, it covers firearms, knives, and other weapons. It's something I got to think about. You know, if I'm at a shopping mall, there's no shopping mall around here, but if I'm at a mall or a public place and something goes down, what's going to be my response? You know, it might be helpful to decide what you want to do given the scenario. If you're there with your wife and kid, your priority may be, hey, I'm gonna get my wife and kid out of there. I'm gonna use my firearm to defend them, because they're my priority. I don't have a wife and kid, of course, but that may be your priority, and that's completely legitimate. It may, your decision may be, I'm gonna get myself out of here. That's what I'm doing, and I don't blame you for that either. Or you may decide, I'm gonna go in, I'm gonna take on this threat, neutralize this threat, try to save lives. It's a very admirable position, very noble. It's a risk that you're taking by doing that, because if you do that, then there's a risk that the police may show up and they may mistake you as a shooter. That's very, very possible. So I'm not really chastising anybody from making that type of mistake, as long as they at least try. separate the bad guy from somebody who may have a CCW trying to help the situation. That's difficult. Do the police come in with the guns and saying, "Please drop your weapon," or do they just come in and they see the guy and they start shooting? I don't know. Hopefully they make some measures to try to decide whether this person's a bad guy or not. But it's difficult putting yourself in that situation where you got to go in there and you got to do it. The family's coming out saying that if their son were a white person, if he was a white guy, this wouldn't have happened. It would have been a different outcome. I don't know if that's true or not. Maybe. I don't know. I've never even been to Alabama. You know, I have my perception of different places. But until I go there, and I don't really have solid opinions about places or departments or anything. I don't know what was going on in this officer's head. But the fact that the police department's handling the situation the way that they are makes more people wonder, okay, well, especially me, okay, well, what else is going on here? We haven't seen the body cam. Are they hiding something? Are they waiting to things cool down? Then they're going to try to show us, or they're going to hope that we just sort of just shut up after a while? You know, I mean, again, I don't have enough information to really start blaming anybody. I'm just saying the perception is really important. That's something that police departments really got to look at. But, you know, it's all about balancing that. You guys, share your thoughts. If you were a concealed carry permit holder, you were in that situation, what would you do if there was gunshots? And would you try to intervene? Would you try to head on out of there and protect yourself or whatever? Either way, I'm not knocking you for either decision. You know, but if you do try to intervene, there's a possibility that the police may mistake you as being the bad guy, and that's the risk you take. So that's the risk you take is more than just encountering the active shooter. A lot of times when the good guy challenges or goes against or tries to stop the active shooter just turns a gun on him or herself. I don't know what happened in this situation. I hope they find a real bad guy, and my condolences go out to this family, this Bradford family. It looks like their son tried to do the right thing, tried to do something. And then he lost his life. So, you guys share your thoughts. Do you think race would have mattered in this situation? Hard to tell, not a lot of information. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.